How about another fog? Radiation fog. This is fog produced by the cooling of air in contact with a cold ground surface. Doesn't it sound like advection fog? No, because it's not. Advection implies movement. It means wind. In the case of radiation fog, the air has to be perfectly still. If there's wind, it will not set up. Radiation fog occurs on long, cold, clear, calm nights. Do you remember something else that was happening on long, cold, clear nights? Yeah, low-level inversions. And if you remember, I also mentioned that there was a fog that was associated with low-level inversions. Remember, low-level inversions means the air that's in contact with the ground is colder than the air above it, and it's because of surface cooling. There's two types of places and two basic forms of this type of fog in California. Let's start with this one. So, first of all, this diagram is actually supposed to be at night. It sort of looks like it's during the day, but it's not. If you look at the left-hand side, it says heat radiating from the surface at night cools the bottom air until it reaches saturation. So, what that means is this: when the sun goes down, the earth continues to lose heat energy. It loses energy into the atmosphere. As it loses energy, the temperature of the ground gets colder and colder and colder. Now, of course, it doesn't reach 0 degrees Kelvin, so it doesn't get that cold. But the surface of the planet continues to get cold, and of course, the air takes on the characteristics of what it's over. The surface of the planet will not begin to get warm again until the sun comes up, shortwave radiation comes in, hits the surface of the planet, and then heats the surface so that there begins to be a surplus of energy in the atmosphere. There's a deficit of energy at night because the planet's losing energy that's not being replaced. Then, as you look to the right-hand side, fog forms first at the surface, thickening as cooling continues. So, the first place that the fog is going to begin to happen is literally right on the ground, because that's going to be the first place where the temperature is cold. My wife and I were out walking, I don't know, a week ago or something early in the morning, and we went by a school that's near us, and the playground in the school is all grass. It's a middle school. And there was about a 2 foot layer of fog over the top of this park. This is just about a week ago. I didn't bother telling my wife about this. She's heard me talk about this stuff so many times, probably drives her crazy. But I made a mental note of it myself. A couple of years ago, I was out jogging early in the morning at the park near my house. And you can see this is early in the morning. The sun's coming up. I had my phone with me. And there was a fog laying over the top of the park. There it is, right there. Why would fog form over the park, or a golf course for that matter, but not over the street? So, right behind my back, as I took this picture, is a street. And there was no fog on the street. Now, you have probably driven home at 2 o'clock in the morning, gone by a park or a golf course, and notice that there's like 6 feet of fog laying over the top of that area there, but over the street there's nothing. Why isn't there fog happening over the street? Well, let me tell you one thing. First of all, the temperature of the ground over the top of the park is the same temperature of the ground over the top of the street. So it's not that the park cooled more. And it's not as if there's millions of cars going by. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. There hasn't been a car go by in an hour. So, what's the difference between what's going on over the park or the golf course and what's happening over the street? Well, it's evapotranspiration, which is the loss of moisture to the atmosphere from plants, soils, and water bodies. Remember, transpiration is the loss of moisture from plants. Evapo means evaporation. And if you have a park or a golf course, there may very well not just be vegetation there, but there may be a little stream there and a lake there. And in fact, in this park that you see there, there is a little lake. And if you're trying to keep it green, especially in California, you probably have to water it, which means sprinklers going on, which dump water in the atmosphere, which means the specific humidity over the top of the park or the golf course is much higher than the specific humidity over the top of the street, which has no vegetation and is not watered. That means the relative humidity is higher over the top of the park or the golf course, and that means that the temperature does not need to drop as much to reach the dew point temperature. So there is just simply more moisture in the air over the top of the park or the golf course, and the relative humidity is higher, which means the air temperature doesn't need to drop as much in order to make the magic happen. I was riding my bike through Yosemite early in the morning after a rainstorm, and I came across this area where the trees were losing moisture to the atmosphere. I actually have a video of this, and you could see the moisture exuding from the trees, and then about 6 inches away from the trees, it completely dissipates in the atmosphere. That's what transpiration is about, the loss of moisture to the atmosphere from plants. Now, wherever there's plants, the relative humidity and the specific humidity are going to be higher than where there is none. There's another type of radiation fog, not just the fog that forms over the top of a park or a golf course. This in California is generally referred to as valley fog or tule fog in some places due to a type of vegetation that's reedy and it grows in the Sacramento River Delta and in some other places along the coast. What happens is cold air descends from higher elevations into a valley. If the valley has a water source, especially if it has a water source or a lot of vegetation, the air can saturate quickly because remember, cold air does not hold a lot of water. If you take a look here, right there, you can see that there's a fog lane over the top of this part of the Merced River Valley. This is early in the morning. The Sierra Nevada is behind me, and the air has descended off of the Sierra Nevada, settled in the Merced River Valley floor. Of course, there's a source of water, which is the Merced River, and the air is cold because it came down off of the mountain. The air acts like a sponge. It absorbs the moisture, but because it's cold, it cannot hold a lot of moisture, and the fog forms. This is a diagram of how valley fog forms. Air cools at higher elevations. Cold air drains downslope into the valley. The cold air drainage reduces air temperature in the valley, and condensation begins to happen, and fog forms. This is a map of California. You could see on the right-hand side is the Sierra Nevada, circled in red, the highest mountain range that contiguous 48 states. This is the Central Valley of California, which is the Sacramento Valley and the San Joaquin Valley. Sacramento Valley is the northern one-third, and the San Joaquin Valley is the southern two-thirds of the Central Valley of California. Then these are the coastal ranges that run along the coast of California. Now, the Sierra Nevada is the highest mountain range in the contiguous 48 states. Mount Whitney is 14,494 feet, and it's there. The coastal ranges are not nearly as high, but there are mountains that are 5,000 feet high. I have many times driven up on the 101 through the coastal ranges going up to San Francisco from Southern California and seen snow on them. So it happens sometimes. This is a bisection of the state of California. Where I bisected it is, you see where it says Pacific Ocean? Right to the right of that is Monterey Bay. So I'm cutting the state in half right there. Now, if you look, there's the Pacific Ocean. Then you see the coastal ranges, the Central Valley, and the Sierra Nevada. During the winter, especially, the Sierra Nevada gets a lot of snow. Snow is cold. The air that lies over the top of that gets cold. And at night, the cold air descends the Sierra Nevada towards the Central Valley, and it also descends from the coastal ranges into the Central Valley. Cold air descends, warm air rises. Then the Central Valley has a lot of vegetation in it because of agriculture, and of course, that's watered. That air, this is especially true during the winter months, will be warmer than the air that's up in the Sierra Nevada. And that air might only be 40 degrees. But the air that's coming down off the Sierra Nevada might be 20 degrees. And then what happens is the cold air settles on the valley floor and the warm air is forced up. This is the inversion. Can you see that? Cold air on the ground, warmer air above it. Cold air cannot hold a lot of water, but at the same time, there's a lot of vegetation, a lot of agriculture. There's water that's sprayed all over the place to water the vegetation that's there for agriculture. There's rivers that run through there. There's some lakes there. All of that adds moisture to the atmosphere because the air acts like a sponge, but cold air cannot hold a lot of water, and the result is a fog forms. And that fog lies over the top of the Central Valley. It's very common during the winter months. If you look once again, you can see here's the Merced River Valley. This is exactly what's happened. That cold air has descended the Sierra Nevada. It lies over the top of the Merced River Valley. That makes that fog form. You can see also in this picture, this was taken up in Wyoming. It's pretty early in the morning. It's like 5:30 in the morning or something, but I was coming along and I saw this fog lane over the top of the valley. The Teton Mountain Range is behind me, which is 14,000 feet high. Cold air drains down off of that mountain range, settles over the top of that valley, and there's actually a little stream that runs through it. And as a result of that, you get this fog at night, this radiation fog, because the cold air cannot hold a lot of water. Now, had you come back an hour later, the fog would be gone because the temperatures go up.